Welcome to another episode of Kurdistan This Week, where we bring you the latest in the Kurdistan region from NRT Studios in Somani. The Kurdistan region is ready to provide assistance to the victims of the Mosul ferry disaster, Kurdistan Regional Government Prime Minister Netrevan Barzani said on Friday. At least 79 people died when an overloaded ferry sank in the Tigris River on Thursday afternoon. That number is expected to rise. Barzani expressed his condolences to the families of the victims in a phone call with Nineveh Governor Nofal Hamadi, the KRG said in a statement. Barzani said that he had instructed the authorities in Erbil and Duhok to provide assistance to their counterparts in Mosul. NRT digital media reporter Haresh Kadir said that the Directorate of Health in Erbil had sent several ambulances to Mosul City to assist injured people and transfer bodies. On Friday, Iraqi President Barham Salah visited Mosul and was angrily confronted by families of the victims. The families also confronted Governor Hamadi, throwing bricks at his vehicle. Most of the casualties on the ferry were women and children who could not swim, said the head of Mosul's Civil Defense Authority. Mobile phone footage showed the ferry sinking into the muddy water and people shouting for help. Iraqi Prime Minister Adel Abdelmahdi announced 3 days of mourning across Iraq, and KRG officials have announced the cancellation of a number of Newroz events out of respect for the victims. Turkish warplanes bombed four villages in the foothills of the Qandil Mountains in the Kurdistan region, local authorities said on Wednesday. Co-chair of Qandil Municipality, Mohammed Hassan, told NRT Digital Media that the airstrikes had caused no casualties. Earlier on Tuesday, Turkish artillery shelled Dereşke village in Amedi district, northeast of Duhok, which also caused no casualties. Turkey intermittently carries out strikes against suspected PKK positions in the Kurdistan region. Last Saturday, the city of Halabja marked the 31st anniversary of the genocidal chemical attack that took the lives of thousands of people in 1988. At the hall next to Halabja Stadium, thousands of dignitaries, survivors, and ordinary citizens gathered to remember the victims and to honor the survivors. Senior diplomats representing the United Nations and embassies and consulates in Iraq and the Kurdistan region were in attendance during the solemn ceremony. People from across the Kurdistan region also visited the city's iconic monument to visit the museum and remember the terrible crime committed against the city and those who lived there. Prime Minister Abdelmahdi released a statement expressing his condolences to the people of the Kurdistan region and Halabja. On March 16, 1988, the Ba'ath regime attacked the city using mustard gas, nerve agents, and possibly cyanide. Poisonous fumes spread across the city, and the mostly civilian victims died in clumps throughout the city's residential areas. Many others managed to survive and escaped into Iran. As many as 5,000 people were killed, and thousands more were wounded. Many of the residents of Halabja became separated from their families in the chaos of the attack and were never able to make contact again. Victims of the chemical attack still suffer the effects to this day, both psychologically and medically. The Kurdistan Democratic Party and the Patriotic Union of Kurdistan have agreed to hold more talks after the Newroz holiday, a KDP spokesperson said Tuesday. Delegations from the KDP and the PUK met in Somani, but afterwards did not indicate that any tangible progress had been made towards resolving their differences. Speaking during a press conference, KDP spokesperson Dilshad Shabab said that the meeting was successful and that they had made good steps, but did not elaborate. More than 2 weeks ago, the parties signed an agreement that had raised hopes that they were close to forming a government. Finally, the people of the Kurdistan region celebrated the Newroz holiday this week, with celebrations starting on Wednesday. In Erbil, thousands of people gathered in Shanidar Park, while in Somani, people strolled along Salim Street in traditional Kurdish clothes. In Duhok, the main celebrations took place in Newroz Park, and in Kirkuk, Kurds, Arabs, and Turkmens gathered at the citadel to celebrate the occasion. And Akre, in Duhok province, always holds a large celebration that includes a torch run to the top of a nearby mountain. Newroz, or New Year, represents a time of renewal and celebration across the Kurdistan region and around the world. Typically held in late March, the celebration marks the beginning of spring and celebrates Kurdish history and the story of Newroz. Bonfires are lit to represent the passing of winter's darkness and the coming of spring's light. Thanks for tuning into this episode of Kurdistan This Week. If you'd like more information on these stories and others, check out our website, nrttv.com/en, and be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter.